गेट रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन स्टार्ट. वाइल द वेवर ऑफ द इंटरेस्ट ऑन इंटरेस्ट इज वेलकम, MSMEs need more help. The center's scheme to bear the difference between the compound interest and simple interest on retail and MSME loans availed by borrowers whose aggregate outstanding borrowings were less than rupees 2 crore between March 1 and August 31 has come not a day too soon. In spelling out the norms for lenders to identify eligible beneficiaries and then ensure that the extra interest on interest be refunded by November 5, the government has clearly been spurred by the Supreme Court's admonition to expedite relief to small borrowers. With the top court having pointedly referenced the approaching festival of lights when it said the common man's Diwali was in the government's hands, the center has ended up setting a really tight deadline of less than 2 weeks for banks and NBFCs to credit the differential amount to the borrowers' accounts. The lenders have their task cut out to make sure that they pick out all the eligible loans, education, housing, consumer, durables, automobiles, consumption, credit card borrowings, as well as credit provided to MSMEs, and that the borrowings had not turned into non-performing assets as on February 29. They will then have to refund the difference between the compound interest charged for the 6 month period and the simple interest. In making all the specified borrowers eligible for the ex gratia, the government has sought to ensure equity between those who may have availed of the repayment moratorium and others who had opted to continue to service their borrowings. The move, however, has understandably evoked both relief and some disquiet. Retail borrowers, especially those who continued to meet their EMI commitments notwithstanding the disruptions caused by the pandemic and lockdowns, stand to marginally benefit from the government's payment and will be a relieved lot. On the other hand, MSMEs may find the assistance far too small to make a material difference given the scale of economic hardship they have had to ensure, from demand destruction to material and labor shortages and regulatory woes. Given that these businesses provide substantial direct and indirect employment and also generate valuable tax revenue, it would have made far greater economic sense for the government to have categorized them separately. The additional fiscal impact should be seen against the benefit that would accrue when even a reasonable number of these enterprises to remain viable and resume their contribution to the national economy. Also, the rupees 2 crore limit for retail loans provides succor to not just vulnerable borrowers but creates a moral hazard by benefiting the well-heeled too. All eyes will now be on the court when it resumes hearing the matter next month. Stop.